this box right here is roughly 1 foot long, and I can't tell you any other dimensions about it. I can just tell you it's roughly 1 foot long. And I only know that because in the book, the object in this box, I believe, is maybe less than 1 foot. In a long, long time. Inside this box is the wand of one Harry Potter. Gesture, but not one I expected. It's kind of too big to get in frame. The frame is almost exactly 1 foot, or it's a little less, so I can't get the full wand in here. But let's open it up. Gender in the book, as far as I remember. The wand itself is not made of wood, unfortunately. That would have been very nice, but I'm sure it would have been way more expensive if it was actually made of, like, real wood. It's instead made of, like, a high-density polymer or plastic, I think. I mean, honestly, it's probably just a die cast and then a mold filled, and it's still probably like $70 or something. I mean, the detail is good on it. It has a lot of ornate, high quality details on it. It has a whole bunch of lines and lining. The further you get on the wand, the less detailed it is, but I guess you expect that, because after everything, a wand is just a stick, a pointed stick, so you want it to be smooth at the end, the way you're, the end you're pointing. But yeah. closest wand, if I were to buy my own recreation of a wand. But of course I'm not gonna decline a gift, because of course this was a gift from my friend. I like Ron, Ronald Weasley. I don't know if I have a particularly favorite Harry Potter character. I kind of like Draco Malfoy, but that's just like because I like villain characters.